Hi everyone. I've been asked by a few of my friends how I managed to get this background done here, the sky, this cloud, the clouds and the grass. So today I decided to share the secret with you, which is not a big secret. So let's get started. The first thing you'll do is add a square punch. I clicked on it twice. And then once you have that selected, computer is a bit slow here. You will stretch your punch a little bit bigger than the card so that you make sure that all the areas on the edges will be covered. The second thing you'll do is select a designer paper. It doesn't matter, any designer paper will work just fine. Then you'll double click on it and make sure that you take it out of your actually crop selected area. So by shrinking it, zooming out, it actually moves out of the picture quicker. Then you'll do drop shadow, and we will make it about, you know what, I think it's like 35%, and then close to full, but not quite. It's the sky. So let's do it in bashful blue, and then we'll do okay, and then we'll do okay again. Here you go. Now you have your sky. Second thing you'll do a Command C, Command V if you have a Mac, or Control C, Control V if you have a regular PC, and just move it down there. As you can see, I still have like a bit of a white gap, sorry, a white gap in between the sky and the what will soon become the grass. So again, now I have all the settings already done. All the work is done for me. So all I have to do is go back to the drop shadow key button again, sorry, and then change the color from bashful blue, and I use Pear Pizzazz in this case. And then you'll do okay, and then the grass is there. So now you can move it up a bit so that your gap in between the two, the sky and the grass, is less visible. Then to make those lovely clouds, again, I use the punch. So using the search feature, I will start typing in cupcake. Oops, cupcake, not capcake. Cupcake, and now I have the tub punch, right? So apply, and then you close out of there so you can actually see what it is that you're doing. So once you have your sorry, first cloud, just go ahead and change the color to color fill in white. Here we go, and then again, we'll do the drop shadow feature. And because I want my shadow to be kind of all around the cloud, I'll just change my offset to 0 and 0 again. I will play with the blur and the fill until I'm actually happy with the way it might look. So I think that this in bashful blue kind of should look cool. So we'll go ahead and change that to blue. And then if I do okay and okay again, this is what my cloud looks like, and I'm happy with the result. I think it's going to look great. So just do Command C, Command V, or Control C, Control V, and then just move your clouds around, and then just have fun changing the size of them. And then you can actually, if you don't think that the shadow is there like enough, you can make it more, change the opacity to something that it's more opaque, basically. And again, you do Control C, Control V, or Command C, Command V, depending on what type of a computer you're using. And then you play with your clouds, and you have fun, and you can have a gazillion of them, or just three. Make it big, make it small. And MDS is so much fun. It's so easy. And if you don't like it, you just do delete on your just select. Just make sure you select the thing, the item you want to remove. If not, then you can always do a undo. So basically, this is how I got my clouds, my sky, as well as my grass done. And I hope this is actually giving you a hint and understanding how to use MDS. It's so much fun. Don't be afraid. Just play with it. And there's so many neat tricks out there. So just keep playing. Bye.